Well, the government's move to grant former Pakistani cricketer Javed Miada the visa for the final one day between India and Pakistan has sparked a major controversy. Questions are being raised about why his links with India's most wanted terrorist, Daud Ibrahim, were overlooked and why no preconditions were set before granting him a visa.
The move to give Javed Miada a visa for the final India-Pakistan ODI has raised eyebrows across the nation, mainly because of Miada's family ties with India's most wanted terrorist, Daud Ibrahim.
We are talking here about the relationship between. The relationship is well known.
So if the relationship is known,
should we be blind?
So what's the big deal about that?
Why should it not be a big deal?
Somebody should have taken a call on that.
Somebody has not.
I think it's fine.
Should we shut our eyes as Indian citizens and watch this carry on?
That strong reaction because of Miada's close links with the man behind the D company, Daud Ibrahim, a terrorist who masterminded the 1993 serial blasts, killing 260 innocent people, a terrorist who waged war against India.
Their friendship goes well back into the cricketing career of Mr. Miada. And this is involved with money laundering, it's involved with hawala, with fixing of matches.
Chorus is growing, either to review the visa given to Miada or set preconditions for his visit to India.
I'm not saying don't give Pakistanis visas to come and watch cricket. All I'm saying is deny visa to people, at least as the first point to convey to Pakistan that you are not going to suffer people like Javed Miada in your own country, unless he's willing for some kind of investigation and aid the investigation on Daud Ibrahim.
While the debate rages over the move to roll out the red carpet for Javed Miada, one question is doing the rounds. Shouldn't the government have set preconditions before granting the visa to Javed Miada? Bureau Report, Times Now.